We are going to introduce arts integration. First, before introducing arts integration, we recall the definition of demand integration. Now, what is demand integration? For this, we consider a partition P of cone interval AB. By partition P of cone interval AB, we mean the set of points x0, x1, x2, xi minus 1, xi, xn, where a is less than equal to x0, less than equal to x1, less than equal to x2, and so on, less than equal to xi minus 1, less than equal to xi, less than equal to so on, less than equal to xi minus 1, less than equal to xn, equal to b. So we have taken the point A, the end point A, x0 and the end point B as xn. So here total number of points are n plus 1, beginning from x0 up to xn, and it divides this cone interval AB into n parts, n sub intervals, and this is the ith sub interval, xi minus 1, xi. Now we write delta xi equal to xi minus xi minus 1. This actually gives the length of this subinterval. Delta xi gives the length of the subinterval. This xi minus 1, xi is the upper limit minus lower limit. This gives the length of this subinterval. So delta xi denotes xi minus xi minus 1, where I goes from 1 to up to n. First we recall demand integration before going through demand stages integration. Demand integration of a real function. Let f be a bounded function, bounded real function defined on closed interval AB. Corresponding to each point, each partition P of closed interval AB, we put capital MI equal to least upper bound of fx, where xi minus 1 is less than equal to x, is less than equal to xi. It's small mi is equal to greatest lower bound of fx, where xi minus 1 is less than equal to x, is less than equal to xi. Actually, these are the two bounds in this subinterval, xi minus 1, xi of fx. We have so many bounds, upper bounds and lower bounds. So we here consider the least of the upper bounds and the greatest of the lower bounds. So whenever we talk about bounds of the function fx, it will always mean least upper bound and greatest lower bound. And we denote integral a to b upper bar fx dx by greatest lower bound of upf. Sorry. Here also we write upf equal to sigma mi, capital mi delta xi, where I is from 1 to n, and npf equal to sigma a small mi delta xi, I equal to 1 to n, and integral a to b upper bar fx dx is equal to greatest lower bound of upf, integral a to b lower bar fx dx equal to least upper bound of npf, where least upper bound and greatest lower bound is taken for all partition P of closed interval AB. Here upf and npf, these two expressions, this is called the upper sum of a over closed interval AB, and this is called, NPF is called lower sum of function f over closed interval AB. Integral a to b upper bar fx dx. Integral a to b upper bar fx dx and integral a to b lower bar fx dx. These are called upper integral and lower integral of the function f over closed interval AB. Now, if these two integrals are equal, that is upper integral a to b upper bar fx dx is equal to lower integral a to b your bar occurs the x, then you say that the function f is R integrable over open AB. Now in the next video, we shall discuss the properties, and the main topic remains Stieltjes integral. So please wait for the next video.